fine, babe.
What's wrong?
I've been transferred to the Abeokuta branch.
What? Tell me you're joking.
I'm serious, babe. The board of directors made that decision today.
No way.
At the meet.
What about the wedding?
I know about the wedding, baby, but the Ogunste branch is drowning by the day, and the fear.
And it has to be you. Why didn't they pick someone else to go and represent the company? Why? Why? Does it have to be you?
Sweetheart, calm down.
Look,
babe. These people have a lot of confidence in me. They believe I can do the job.
No, no.
Babe. Take it easy now. I promise you, I'll speak with my mom about it again. And I'm sure we'll work something out.
Your mom is the NDC, or
she will do something. I'm positive. Babe. Come on. Come now. I don't want to go to. I don't want to leave you here by yourself. I don't want to be all by myself over there because I'm going to miss you. Babe, you know I love you so much and I'll do anything to be in the same space as you. So please just calm down. I'll speak to mom again and we'll see what happens. Come on now. Don't let this ruin the night. Don't ruin the night for us.
Don't let them take you, please.
I'll do my best, baby.
We should take somebody else.
Well, if they don't have an option.
No, man, not at all. I had nothing to do with it. It was a corporate decision.
Yes. The board decided that. Oh well, if push comes to shove, I'm afraid it might come to that. A postponement of 6 months max, ma.
Yeah, I spoke to her about it. She understands. She totally understands. Yes, ma.
Yes. Not at all. It doesn't affect anything at all. Plans and preparations are still in top gear. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Absolutely. Demian is here. He's here. He's not traveling. Yes, he'll be in Lagos. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Let's not forget, ma'am. I don't know. Did you get the package I sent you?
You like it? Great. I'm quite humbled, ma'am. Thank you.
Ami, thank you, man. So I'll just see you briefly on my way out tomorrow. I'll stop by your office. Okay, man. All right. Good night.
Why?
I don't know, man. I had to be political about it because there's no way we're not going to move this wedding. This movement to Abeokuta definitely would affect mine. So.
You don't have a choice.
Because I don't intend to spend the rest of my life in the state. So I'm just going to go in there, fix the human resource problem, you know, inject programs that will get the people, the community involved, and max 3 months I'm out. Right?
Yeah, you're the magician, so do your magic.
Yeah, plus I'm getting married to the most beautiful woman in Nigeria. And I do not intend in any way to jeopardize that.
Grace.
Well,
she's just another woman.
No, Kimberly is different. Kimberly is not just another woman. Kimberly is different. She's in a class of her own. All right? Look, you know, we live in a time where women are very, very, you know, somehow. Or you have our slay queens, very funny home training. But you see this one? She is different. She's morally upright. She's faithful. She's trustworthy. She is. Did I mention that she's hot? Have you seen her lately?
Hot, yeah.
But she's just a woman. She's hot.
Is it my cheek you're describing like poison? What's wrong with you, man?
Okay, she's hot.
The girl is hot. You know how hard it is to. Do you know how hard it is to find a dark skinned girl that is beautiful?
Say, Kimberly is special.
Okay, you say.
Let me ask Kimberly.
Okay. Hey.
Really? Can I even live without you? Huh?
You know, that's not even possible. I won't last a day without you, babe.
But then you're going to leave me all alone in this big house.
I'm going to be with you at all times.
No.
You know, I've been thinking of a possible postponement. No, just a little postponement.
No, babes. You are not postponing anything. You said you're going to be away for just 3 months and then you'll be back.
Yes, I said
so. We are not postponing anything. Come on now.
Babe, look, I just want to be back here and settled fully before we get married. All right? I don't want to be married and living single.
No one says you're going to be married and be living single. Come on now, babes. We're not doing this, though. No, we're not. You said you'll be away for 3 months. I'm giving you 3 months. Go do your bit and come back to me in one piece.
Is that what you want?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, fine. Then let's do it. Alright? Alright, I have to go. Am I forgetting something?
Your bag is downstairs.
Yeah, car key, phone downstairs. Okay, so good. Let's go.
There's no postponement. Thank you.
I know you won't miss me. I know you're not going to miss me.
I'm not going to miss you because I know you're going to come back every weekend to see your beautiful wife-to-be.
You sound so sure, huh?
Mm-hmm. I know that.
You know her? Mm. Okay, it's fine. We'll see. All right, I have to get to the office, clear out a few things, you know, before I head out.
Okay.
What?
I love you.
I know you do, baby, and you know that I love you, too. Mm, come here. All right, I have to go.
Mm-mm.
What?
One more?
Mm. One more? You know, we could take one for the road.
I don't mind.
You don't mind, no. All right.
So that I can run late. Walk me to the cabin.
Really, Mom? Or you went back to smoking?
After everything you've been through, Mom, I thought you stopped. Huh?
I did, Grace.
And what is this?
When you get married and you have a son who means everything to you and is living for months and there's nothing you can do about it, then you can understand how it feels. Are you ready to go?
I mean, you make it sound like I'm going away, not to return. I'm going to Ogun State. I'm going to work to return. I'm just irritated and disappointed that you went back to smoking.
You don't raise your voice at me, Chris. I'm still your mother. And remember, I am still the managing director and the chief executive officer of this company. You don't talk to me like that, son. I expect the best from you over there. I know you can do it.
How about my wedding, Mom? How come we're not talking about it?
Chris, you can marry her from the moon if you like. Anything can be done from anywhere. The jet is ready to fly you.
I'll drive.
That's not safe, and you know that.
Mom, I'll be fine. I'll call you when I get there.
Yourself up.
So, Duke, when are you leaving tomorrow?
I was going to leave by 5. 5:36, because we had scheduled a morning meeting for 9 a.m. But I called them to reschedule, make it known. You know, there's no point. What's the hurry? You know, I get there, say, what? 10 a.m. prep. And by 12, we'll sit and talk.
Come on. Don't let me worry. You know, I shall win here.
Of course. What else? You will win.
I shall win. I shall win. So, you go, I shall win. I shall win. And listen.
Corporate, I shall win. Place of correction.
Sorry. I can get you.
No, I'm fine. What's wrong with you? I'm fine. I'm going home to Kimberly.
You'll be traveling tomorrow.
Kimberly is waiting. I'm going home to Kimberly. I'm fine.
Okay. I get it. I'll be sleeping here tonight. Don't worry, not in the office, Larry, but you just crash with me tonight.
Yes.
You know, you're here with them.
Stop. Please stop.
I don't know. Stop.
No, you fucked up the last time.
How many times have
you fucked up big time?
How many times have I told you not to use the F word? Sorry, dude. Okay, about the Ajakuta business.
Yes. You know, I told you I'll be back every weekend to see Kimberly. Okay. So what I had planned was one of my trips back to Lagos, I would see the chairman and then we finalize. So once that is done, I'll just update you.
Do you know why I brought that up?
Yeah.
Mama is so pushy about it.
I know, but things would work out right. Things will work out right. Our inside man told me that, you know, the contract is looking good, given our antecedents. You know, that we'll have a very good record and that they're willing to do business with us. Okay. You know, so we're just doing the final paperwork, and once that we push that in, I come in one of the weekends, I can sit down with this man and then we'll talk and we're fine.
That should be time. Is it time? We are coming at him and looking for him this evening.
She can.
I
can't wait.
I shall be here.
I'm not going to marry a prostitute.
I'm not a prostitute,
Oga? Oga? Ah, you have come. Welcome, oh.
Oga, Oga. Money has money. It has been money since, so. Oga? How is it? How was the journey?
Sorry, you are just waking up. Oga? I've missed you. All the others, I did not do well. So when you were coming, I told everybody that Oga, real Oga, my real Oga is coming. I said it.
It's fine. What time is it?
10 a.m. sir. Even all the welcome team, they are waiting for you. In the new I told them that my Oga, my real Oga is coming. I told them, I explained to them. And I told them.
Hello, D.
Man of the hour. Living this morning, I guess.
Yeah, I traveled last night.
Are you kidding me? You flew? Finally?
No, I drove.
That's impossible.
I drove through the night.
Why?
Long story. What's up? How you doing now?
Oh, sorry. Got to go. I got MD on my trail.
Okay, all right, go. We'll talk later.
So, sir, this is our accountant. Her name is Miss Teresa. She's our accountant.
You're welcome, sir.
Our accountant. Pete Oga well now.
You're welcome, sir. Uh-huh.
And this is also the secretary. Her name is Mrs. Happy Mbola.
Please. You're welcome, sir.
And finally, our high tea. This is the high tea, the head of high tea. His name is Mr. Abiodun. You are welcome, Mr.
Abiodun.
Yes. That's our IT.
Why is he wearing sunglasses in the office? Why?
No, sir.
I did hear you.
I'm preparing the first story, sir.
Sorry. Why are you dressed like that?
Talking now. Yes, this is head of the
question. It's nice to meet you, sir.
What's your name?
My name is Miss Alexa Thomas.
Miss Thomas, we have work to do here. Thank you. I need all the human resource files. All of them. I need to know how many people we have working here and what exactly they do. I also need you immediately to send an internal memo to all unit heads. I want the SOPs today.
Okay, sir.
Alright?
Yes, sir.
You guys are not married. I mean, you're not married to him yet.
Wait. You're joking, right?
I am them.
You are not serious at all.
I am them serious about this. I mean, Chris is just my common friend. I mean, he's acting up so saintly as though he's innocent. And we know! You know he's not. See, I never want to talk about this. But Chris is not.
Yes, I know a lot. Boss, can I get back to your office because I have a lot on my desk?
Oh. shit, you know. I care so much about you. And I'll always be here for you.
Did I know you?
Yeah.
I know you, right? Do you know Daniel? You mean I can call?
Yes. We met at the bar.
Exactly, we met at the bar. It's been a while.
How you doing?
Fine, don't mind me. I've been out of town. You know, it's so good to see you again.
Yeah, nice to see you too.
Babe, you good?
Yes. Kim, I'll see you tomorrow.
All right.
Take care of yourself.
Have a nice
all right, take care of yourself.
All right.
As I was saying earlier, Power Foundation is an organization that we say no to rape. We say no to domestic violence in any form, be it male, be it female. It's a no to female circumcision and no to child marriage in any part of the world. We have started this organization in a while, and I believe that every one of us are here for the same cause. It might be for different purposes, but we still are on the same course for the purpose of minimizing any form of abuse, if not to eradicate it totally. We believe that our coming together here with one voice will have a stronger voice to help that woman that is suffering in silence in the society. No matter what your opinions are, no matter how little, no matter how large, it all counts. And every one of us has a role to play. And I always tell you that when you're coming to the meeting, try as much as possible to tag a friend along. At the end of the day, we need to snowball into a big society. And it's when we snowball into a big society that people will hear our stronger voice, one voice of that thing that we do not want in our society. Moving forward, we have a friend. We have a new member in our society. Please join me in welcoming Debbie.
Good day, everyone. My name is Debbie. I was a victim of child marriage. My father married me off to his friend at the age of 13, and I was unhappy.
So, how was school today?
Yeah, it is.
What did you make? Rice and steam with salad.
Did madam eat?
Mommy.
Daughter. She did.
Thank God. Okay. You're free to go home now.
Bye. You have your bag. Where's your bag?
I didn't even know when I was
coming. Okay.
Right. So my baby, how was school today?
School was fine. Mom, guess what?
What?
We have a new neighbor.
Really?
Yes.
That means we might have a new friend.
Maybe.
Kim. You can move in here with me if you want.
I'm not supposed to be here. I was engaged to him. Engaged to be married to him. I should not be here.
Come on, babe. Can you just forget the past and face your challenges?
Why are you sounding like you're excited about the fact that this whole thing is happening to me? Are you happy? Are you happy that I am in this position? Are you excited? Babe. Does it make you happy?
I'm not glad that your heart is broken. But yes, I am glad I is off you. It did not deserve you. It never will. Baby, I can make your life easier for you in and out of the office. I can help you reach your goals. Look at me. I'm willing to do whatever it takes to make you happy.
Are you saying that you truly love me?
From the depths of my heart. I love you, Kim. I do really love you. I love you. And I always love you. I do love you. I love you.
Hello, Mom.
I presume you have gone to the office by now and have started work. That's the reason why I called. I want to know if I can go ahead and choose a venue for the reception.
I don't know.
Come on, Chris. And Kim, has she selected the colors she wants?
Look, Mom, I really, really, really do not have the energy for this right now. I'm tired, I'm worn out, I'm exhausted.
Just the first day and you are this exhausted? You have to do better than this, my son. Anyway, I will leave you alone for now.
I'm tired. I'm getting frustrated with this constant talk about wedding. What is it? I am here to work. I am here to freaking work. Let me work. Don't tell me I'm shouting. Don't tell me that I am shouting. I can scream out my lungs if I freaking work. I am here to work. What? I was in Lagos. You don't want me to work.
You know I love wedding bells. I just, even if it's a million miles away, I cannot just miss wedding bells. Anyway, my friend, how are you and how is the preparation going? Tell me.
I'm fine. But there are no wedding bells.
You think you live in a vacuum? And the walls have ears. You know, that's my specialty.
The wedding has been called off.
That is an expensive joke.
Oh. Look, don't worry. We'll talk about it after work, okay?
Are you serious? Mm-hmm. I hope you're fine.
I'm fine. And how are you?
I'm fine. Do you know what? Victor has just been transferred to.
Wait, Mr. Victor?
Yes, sir.
When? Why? He just waved and everybody's concentrating on his work. They just saw Victor.
I'm telling you.
How come I did not hear about it?
My dear, let me come and go before somebody start preaching sermon for me.
After work, please, please.
Alright.
This is nice, but a bit too open. Okay, let me show you something else. Oh, hold it. This is lovely. It's gorgeous.
You like it?
Yeah. What shoe would go with this one?
I think a silver colored shoe should go.
Okay. Then I'll call my shoe supplier in the UK.
Okay.
So, we're done with this. Let's see the kicks you have.
Okay, let me quickly just quickly open it. Here we go.
You see, my son doesn't have a taste. That's why I have to do all this by myself. Because if you should allow these children to do anything, you will be shocked.
You must really love your son.
That's an understatement. I love him.
Okay, look at this one. I think this is beautiful.
Oh my god, this is superb. I can bet this is the best of all the cakes you have here.
Yes, and exquisite.
And definitive. I want an elaborate wedding for Chris. Because his wedding is the first in the family. And you know, it should make a statement.
I agree.
Concerning the limo, have you made an arrangement for it or I should cross over bed myself?
Relax, Ma. Everything has been covered. Remember, it's a part of the elephant package you paid for.
Thank you.
Morning, Mom. Mom, I'm in the office. No, I have not done that yet. Hey. Unless it's stopping. Mom, don't worry about it. I'll handle it my own way. Please.
Mr. Sirius said I should call you.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
Hi, babe.
Hey.
How are you?
I'm alright. What's the occasion?
Okay.
Can you close your eyes?
Please close your eyes.
Okay.
Good girl. Okay, wait, a sec. Look at you, so.
I love it, it's so nice. Wait. You don't do this all the time. Why are you doing this? What's the catch?
Yeah, that's true. I'm just trying to be more romantic this time. Is that correct?
It's really nice. I love it. Well, thank you so much. I really love it. But then, I need to get back to work. I have a lot on my desk.
This time around, the tunnel will stop. Throw you back.
Yeah. It's working hours.
Please.
Isn't this funny? How you address me as sir after bossing me around?
Well, sir, I'm the boss in my home, and you're the boss here.
At my home.
Did I do that?
You know, why don't we just go home together since we are neighbors?
I have a few stuffs to do before getting home.
Where and where?
I have a women group movement that I've been running for a while. It's called PARA, Passion Against Women in Africa. It's an advocacy thing that I've been trying to build for some years. And also, I need to get to supermarkets.
Brilliant. There is indeed more to you than meets the eye, Alexa.
Thank you.
I'd like to tag along.
Tag along?
Yes.
No way. It's an all-female group. Besides, I don't want to waste your time.
Who says you'll be wasting my time? This town is already left behind, so what would I possibly be doing with my time?
It's all female.
And I am sure, Alexa, that we can change the law sometimes to permit donors to show up, even if it's just once. I insist. Great. You know what? Give me a few minutes to tidy up. I'll be with you. All right?
I never knew I got married to an homosexual. And for the past years we were together, I went through hell. This is my story.
Thank you very much, Jane. It's quite unfortunate that you have to go through that. We all have different stories to tell. And at each point in time, you should be able to understand that no matter how weighty your story may have been, some other person might be going to something worse than what you have gone through. Like I always say, in para is not meant for the abused only, or the raped, or domestic violence. It has other cogent issues that we have to deal with, that we have to understand and are dealing with. How do I mean? Domestic violence, for instance, is not restricted to the female folks alone. Even the male folks are victims as well. Aside the fact that as women, we should be able to understand that we should show love to at each point in time. That is when we can carry the weight of that person next to you. When you have pain inside, if you voice out your emotions, it goes a long way to relieve you of such pains. And showing love should be devoid of our race, our age, our culture, our background, our religion. Should just be the fact that you want to show love to that next person. You want to be a shoulder to cry on to that next person. That is the very essence of this women liberation movement. I want us to see beyond the fact that we are fighting a cause on some restrictive subject, but understand that it is an embodiment of everything that has to do with the women's vote. Even in the inclusion of the corporate victimization as well. The corporate inequality that the male should dominate some part of the corporate world is for us to understand that we have to fight to a level where we as women will triumph over every form of abuse that might be working against us. Talking about the male folks, we have a male amongst us today. Please join me in welcoming Mr. Christopher Adetoko Manelsi.
Thank you so much for allowing me be here. Yeah, as awkward as it may seem, thank you. And I want to say that I like and I believe everything that I have seen here and heard here today. And I would also like to say that if there's anything that I can do, please allow me to contribute my quota to ensure that this has massive effect and then the message that you preach here goes as far as it can go.
Let's continue as we have Hawa tell us about her circumcision story.
You know, flashing back, that was quite.
It was quite a powerful speech you gave there. You know, because it just makes me think a lot about the disparity in the world that we live in.
Yeah. You know, a lot of times we do something wrong about something, and also nothing about something wrong most times. So it's just, I don't know, I guess it's just, I don't know where to place it.
Wow. So you've been around this circle for a long time?
Oh, well, for quite some time. Actually, what motivated me to get this started was my mom and dad. My dad always cheats on my mother, and it's regarded as normal. I say there's nothing wrong in a guy cheating on his wife. And when my mom did the same, all hell went loose. It was an abomination. I ask myself, why so much disparity between the man and his wife? If a man can do it and he gets away with it, why shouldn't the woman be able to do it and get away with it as well?
Yeah, right. What can I say? The imbalance in perspectives.
Yeah, I guess so. So, tell me, what does it take to be a Nelson?
I don't know. I've pretty much been a Nelson all my life, so I really cannot tell the difference from being a Nelson and being someone else.
I meant your dad, your mom, your siblings, all that.
No, I have fond memories of my father while he was here. Sad enough, I lost him when I was just 12. You know, but I remember him as a man who was ahead of his time, generation, quite innovative. His primary purpose, as I was told, was setting up this empire, which he succeeded in doing, but then we lost him quite early. But the silver lining to all of this is that my mom carried on well after he passed on. Yeah. You know.
She did it very well, but how was she able to come this far?
Oh, well, hard work, I like to think. You know, in the African setting, when a woman loses her man, you know, you have a lot of woes. But in her case, she was lucky. She had people who believed and supported her dream. Given the fact that she's also driven, you know, so it was easy to work with these people. So my mom would stop at nothing to get what she wants. She's ready to bring down all the trees on her way to her. She's going, even now, she's still that way, you know. So I'll just call her a workaholic. I guess my dad was lucky.
So, something about yourself?
Miss FBI, what are you talking
about? Everything to know.
Okay.
Well, as a lot of people know, I was born in Lagos. So pretty much all my life has been in Lagos. I was born in Lagos, went to King's College. Afterwards, I moved on to attend the University of Lagos. And then traveled to the UK for my master's in economics. So, I'm a professional economist.
No wonder you're more British than African.
Am I?
So, outside of your file, who is Christopher Adito Obunnelson?
Arachnophobia. A man who's terribly scared of spiders. Spiders, I have a strong phobia for spiders. Growing up, I remember having my first cousins around the house, and then they would get a spider and then, you know, just put it on my face and I'm like,
I'm sorry.
Kimberly's not answering her phone. Is she all right?
Mom, I believe she's fine. She's probably busy. I told you before, relax. I have this under control. I'll leave it to me. Just leave it to me.
Fine. How are you?
Fine.
I've quit smoking finally for real now.
Good. I thought 1,000 times before, Mom. Please.
I've made up my mind. I'm doing it for you.
I've heard.
Or do you want to come back to Lagos? You could come back if you want, and then me and we replace.
Mom, I'm fine. I'm not complaining, alright? I'm gonna be here for the 6 months that you want me to be here. I'm okay.
You don't have to be hard on me, Chris. You were the only one I could trust.
Mom, I'm fine. I'm not complaining.
Okay, fine.
Look, Dima, let me tell you, when your girl cheats on you, when your woman cheats on you, you can feel it. You would know, you can tell, you can feel it. Well, let me tell you, a woman who truly loves you won't do that to you.
Dear, I don't know of a woman who is in love. But I know a woman who wants to cheat on you will cheat regardless of anything. There's a point. Yeah, their brains stop functioning and their ass takes over.
Not Kimberly. Well, her head is always in the right place. Look, dear, I understand what you're saying. And sometimes certain generalizations might work, but not in her case. Her head is always in the right place and she loves me.
Chris.
What?
What makes Kimberly different?
She is different.
That she's in love with you or that she was well groomed? I am very positive she has not met that one person that has the key to her heart. But when you bully in bed.
I don't agree with you. Look, if you play your cards well, your woman will not cheat on you.
Chris.
What?
Okay.
Damien.
Okay, okay.
Drink, where could they go?
Okay. Okay.
My fiance in bed with another man.
Wow. That's really sad. But you must really love her.
Yes, I did, and that's why I planned to marry her.
Did she love you?
Oh well, what can I say? Already fixed a date for the wedding. Preparations were already in top gear. And I walked in with her pants down, having sex with someone that I know.
Wow.
Ah. You know, the kind of love that I had for Kimberly made me look naive to a couple of my friends. They felt that I was rather too ambitious with the way I felt about her, given the fact that she's a woman. But I didn't see her that way. You know. I have been dealing with this pain all by myself. Not even my friends, not even my mom. I haven't mentioned a word of this to anyone. It's just, I felt like driving myself through a wall and killing myself. I don't know what kept me.
I'm sorry about that. Mommy! Hi, Angel! Be careful there!
Okay. Where's her dad?
He's in the US.
Why? What happened?
Well, I don't want to bore you with that story for another day.
Ah, no, come on. I like to think we have all day. We are here.
Okay. Let us go. Nigeria. He came from the US.
Yeah.
We fell in love. It's about my first time in life that I was going to fall in love.
Wow.
I had fond memories to do that. But along the line, I got pregnant and I noticed changes in him. Just felt maybe I was just overthinking. But lo and behold, I stumbled on some documents, pictures, messages. But I discovered that he had a wife and 4 kids. I felt like a schoolgirl. My whole world came crashing. I didn't want to have to sit here. But guess what? Which is the best part of me right now.
You know, I constantly wonder why bad things happen to good people. Cynthia!
Yes, welcome to my humble abode, small but filled with love. Please make yourself comfortable.
Thank you very much.
What do I offer you? What drink? Water?
No, water. Water is,
sure?
Is perfect.
Okay, please make yourself comfortable. I'll be right back.
Thank you.
Yeah. Yeah, that's cool.
Yeah, I see. You know, I've often wondered how it feels to sit in the car and wait for your kid, you know, run out of school premises and run towards you.
Well, nice, but it could also be challenging as well.
Right, especially when it has to do with you. Okay, there she comes.
Good afternoon, Uncle Chris.
Cynthia, how are you?
I'm fine.
Well, you're surprised I know your name, huh?
Yes.
It's okay. Your mom already told me so much about you.
Okay.
So, this is Uncle Chris officially.
What's unofficial about it?
Mother and daughter have unofficial hours as well.
Okay, shall we?
She's my best friend, so we share everything, despite her age.
Good. It's good. All right, now.
So, sit belt, baby. Damian.
Yes, ma'am.
I invited you back because I have an assignment for you.
Okay, ma'am.
You see, the past 3 months Chris left Fabelkuta. He has made himself incommunicado. Chris neither called nor returns my call. This is my assignment for you. I want you to go to Abeokuta under the next 24 hours and relieve him of his post. Chris should meet me back here in Lagos. And it must be not today. I've spoken.
I'll do just that, ma.
Good. And Damien?
Yes, ma'am.
Is that not cigarette?
Yes, it is, ma'am.
What are you still doing with this? I've stopped smoking myself. Moreover, smoking is dangerous to your health.
Okay, ma'am.
Join the message.
Amen. Keto dry, ma'am.
I will soon. You shall call me.
I want you to arrange a meeting.
Okay.
With all the new staff tomorrow morning. All
right.
Have you sent this out?
As it should be a done deal by now.
Yes, it was done yesterday.
Good. I've also approved this requisition. I will need you to send it to internal control.
Okay, sir.
And the CFO.
Don't forget. Yeah.
Bye bye.
Hello, Mom.
Hello, Chris.
How are you?
Chris.
What is going on?
What are your preparations towards your wedding? Chris, this is not fair. You locked me out. Kimberly is not picking my calls either.
Tell me, son, what exactly is wrong with you? Are you sure you want to go ahead with this wedding? Do you love this girl at all?
Chris, talk to me. I'm your mother.
Mom, I'm at work.
Chris? Hello? Chris?
Hola! Oga! Oga? Yeah. How much is it? Oga is the expensive.
This bill is 4,000.
So, Oga is okay. Yes, 2 years. No further inside the. 4,500. 4,500.
Such a
4,500. Oga is okay. I'll do you like that. There's a way. 4,500, baby.
What's the problem? I can walk. Okay, sir. Okay, sir. I can walk. No problem.
Before you walk, let me just so that once you stand,
Ola,
the walking you do it. I just want to, so that you just stand. Where's your phone, Oga?
I can walk.
Where's your phone?
Ola, I can walk.
Where's your phone? Oga, there's water here. I can't see more. I can't. Oga! Okay. Where is me alone?
I can walk.
I will not leave you because it's me. You will drive. It's like. It's not like that. That's not this way. There's water here. There's water here. I have family. I don't have family. No, I will not leave this place. Let's go.
Oga, is it? Oga, is it? Is it?
back here. Hola! Hola, sit. Hola.
We have reached. Now we have reached. We have to.
Hola.
Now what happened?
Hola, do you know that my wedding is off? I called it off.
Your wedding? Why? What? Why did you?
I called it off.
Why did you call it off?
I'd caught Kimberly. I caught her with a man on my bed.
Ha!
I caught her.
What were they doing?
Man on my bed.
What were they doing on your bed? She and a man. What were they doing?
I caught her. And my mother has been calling me. Calling me. But I tell you this. I tell you this. I would rather make up with Kimberly than have my mother gloat over me. Huh? It will not happen.
Okay, you've not seen what they were doing on your
bed. The wedding is off. The wedding is off. Hola. Tell them I have called off the wedding. Tell them that the wedding.
Psst. Why is it?
Do you hear what I'm saying?
Even though you're not telling me what they do,
she slept it out.
Ha!
I'm going to marry Alexis.
You marry Alexa?
I'll marry Alexa. I'll let Kimberly go. I'll marry Alexa.
Okay, because you said Alexis before. Is he Alexa or Alexis?
I'll marry her. She's a nice girl. People say she's nice.
Okay.
Come. You said come back.
Morning, Oga.
You know Alexa, right?
Aunt Alexa. She's a nice lady. Very nice. Everybody like her. Even in the office, they always talk about her. She's a very nice lady. She's going to dash me money. But there's only one problem. There's one problem. She has born child. She has born child because. But fortunately, I think the man ran away, so they were not able to marry. So only she, she's taking care of the child. Only she. But she's a nice lady. Nice lady. Everybody know. Everybody.
What else?
Is it because yesterday now you say that you want to marry her? Is that why you are asking?
What?
No, yesterday night.
I said that.
You were sleeping and you said that you want to marry her.
What else? What else did I say?
You didn't say more to you just said that you saw Madame Kimberly and your friend. You said that you saw them in the bed that you were telling their certain each other certain that you caught them more than them.
You even said that you canceled the marriage because you caught them doing
you were telling
this is more
like quiet.
Each other started.
What?
Yes, sir. How do you want anybody?
Nobody here. Not even a soul. To hear of what you just told me.
Nobody here, sir. I've even assumed that even me I was drunk.
Tell Alexa.
friend that got married recently. Her husband caught her with his friend. When I was advising her, she wouldn't listen. Now she's calling me. I don't blame the girl, though. I blame the guy.
Why?
When they were dating, he caught her in the act 3 times and he still went ahead and married her.
Even before they got married, the guy already caught the girl sleeping with people.
Yes, ma'am. 3 weeks.
Say that you're nice. Alexa, report from the office.
Pastor Chef, are you enjoying the food?
Yes, my darling, I am.
You were going to be there for me. You said you loved me. I thought I was your girlfriend.
Tell me you're coming.
I didn't know I was coming. Mama sent me here to replace you immediately.
She can't do that. It's not possible.
Chris, what's going on? What's happening to you?
I can't go back to Lagos.
I can't disobey the CEO. Chris.
I know what to do. I'm going to go in there. I'm going to call her and talk some sense into her head. But I still, you know what? I just leave first thing in the morning.
Really. Wait.
Do you, what is it?
Christopher, I am not talking about the wedding or the office feud. All I'm talking about is you, my friend. You've changed. You are a different man now. Like you're very far away from me. You have to remember this. We grew up together. You're my best friend. So what happened? Guy, you can trust me. This couple of months, you've been so far away, and I don't understand it. Please tell me.
It's a long story, Emir. But I will tell to you when I return. Now, I'm tired. I need to sleep. Well, I'll be traveling to Lagos in the morning.
But why? Why? What happened?
My mom.
What about her?
She wants me to. But don't worry. I'll be back the day after tomorrow, I promise you. Okay?
Sure.
I will be back for you.
Sure.
Okay?
Please be safe for me.
I love you, babe. I'll be safe.
What have I done? What is this? What have I done to my life? I should have gone back to bed, Chris. Well, at least he was angry with me. He was hurt. He caught me red-handed, but he was the devil's handiwork. But I caught him in bed with another woman. And then I forgave him. I shouldn't have entangled myself with this devil called Cyril. God. get myself into this mess? How? Oh, now I guess I don't have a choice. I just have to go back and do what is right for me. I need to just go back and wait for Chris. Wait to apologize to him and tell him that I'm sorry. It was the devil's handiwork. It wasn't my fault. Chris is a better man for me. Oh, Kimberly, Kimberly, God help me. What do I do right now? I have to go back to Chris. Yes.
My son, doctor, how is he?
He's fine. He's very fine. We've done all the x-rays.
Okay.
You can sit, relax.
No, I'm fine, I'm fine. Doctor, please, I beg in the name of God, make sure you do everything humanly possible to make sure he's completely okay. He's my only son, and I'm past menopause.
Ma'am?
Yes.
He is fine. We suspect a slight hit to the head, but. He's fine.
Any broken bones?
No.
His ribs?
He is completely fine.
What about the spinal cord? Is he all right?
Well,
yes.
He's fine. Okay. Just take a seat. We'll call you.
I'm fine. I'm fine, doctor. I'm fine.
Come on, sit.
I'll be fine. Thank you.
All right. I'll call you to the office. Right?
Can I go and check on him now?
Give him some time. Let the anesthesia wear out, and you'll be able to see him.
Okay, doctor. Yeah. I'll be fine.
All right.
Thank you.
And also, sir, Mr. Chris is scheduled to have a meeting with the Ajaputa branch for next week, and I don't know what to do about that.
Next week?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Schedule me for the meeting. I will attend. Oh, sorry. Sorry. Excuse me. Hey, dude. Chris, I beg your pardon. What was this? How? Where? Okay, I'll be right there. Alexa, I have to travel now. You tell the management.
Wait, what?
I have to travel now!
Said he has no broken bone, only 8 injuries. Anesthesia, we will soon be awake.
Okay. Hey.
You are back. How are you?
Hey, dude.
Next time you want to get yourself killed, you might want to inform me first. And let me tell you, no more driving for you. Henceforth, you will have a driver. And if you have to travel, you will use the private jet. It's okay?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Chris.
I just want. Look at me. Your mother. It's your mom.
Who are you?
Are you okay?
What can you remember?
Who are these people?
How do you feel?
Joker, do you please talk to me.
Nothing is conclusive right now. We might need to run.
What's going on?
We might have to run a few tests and see. I think he might have suffered a memory loss.
Memory loss?
Maybe.
Ah!
No, no.
Finished. Oh, hello? Hey, babe, so. What? Are you serious? Damian.
Yes, mom.
Don't go rotting me more.
Please calm down. Everything will be okay.
I can't even remember. His mother is forgotten everything. He can't remember anything again.
I don't know if you're okay. I'll see you when she comes back here. So, hey. Will you try to reach?
What's going on? Mommy. I can't. My son can't give me. Not even his mother.
I'm just going to.
Chris is going to be alright.
Okay.
Okay, so where is
he? He's upset. Let me take you to him.
Calm down. 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 Calm down.
Hi, Damon.
Hi, it's okay.
Hi. You guys have to be quick because you know he needs to rest, okay?
Sure, sure.
I'll see you later.
Thank you, it's
okay.
Bye.
Bye.
Kim is here. Kim, baby.
He's been like that for a while now.
Baby? The love of your life, Kimberly, sir.
Kimberly.
Him to remember about you. What are you planning to stop him from remembering until he loves you again?
But what am I supposed to do? Have I not tried? He has lost his memory.
Memory, not tongue. Listen to me. Listen and listen very good. I will advise you. Go on with the wedding plan. Get him married to you. Maybe after you guys are married, you could show him the animalistic love.
That is a brilliant idea. Junior, I did not think about it. Oh my goodness.
But try and discuss that with his mother. And wait until he's been discharged from the hospital.
Ha! My friend, collect it. Yeah. I am going to drink too.
Pay me for this advice.
Not advice. I mean, advice I
have
not given
you.
Have I not given you plenty advice? Do pay me. Yeah. This is what I'm going
to do. No problem. Come back tomorrow. Come back tomorrow.
Yes, my friend. Oh my god, did you
Thank you.
Hello. Yeah, hello. How are you, my dear?
We could get married and then attend the class. Just like sinners become Christians first and then keep coming to church to learn how to live the Christian life.
My dear, but you know that is not the normal procedure for that.
Father, he's unconscious. Can't we make an exception for him? For us?
You know, it is not possible to join people without their consent, their full consent, you know.
What if you can never get the full consent? He might never recall everything.
Don't worry, let's be optimistic that he will be fully okay.
Thank you so much, Father.
How about his mother? I hope his mother is fine.
His mom is doing very fine.
Okay, thank you. My regards to the mother, please.
I have to carry more tests on Chris because he partially recognized Kimberly. And that actually raised my curiosity when it did. This is a case of selective amnesia, but it will recover.
Auntie Joke, please tell me the truth. Nigeria for me. How soon?
Mommy, yes. Don't worry, Chris will get better. He's in good hands. We will take care of him. He will recover.
It is good enough for me to know that he can be healed.
Due to his head injuries, that was why he lost his memory. But don't worry, he will recover.
So what can we do to help him recover?
Joke.
Yes.
Yes. Are there certain foods or drugs or procedure anywhere in the world?
Not really. This is not a black and white part of medicine. But it's often help people in similar situations if they surround themselves with people they've always spent time with. Especially their last few hours before the accident. So it would really help.
Well, we don't even know who he spent his last few days with.
Where was he at the hospital?
I'd like to just know who he spent his last few days with.
Dude, the doctor said you have to be around those you have spent the last few weeks with. Can you remember anyone you shared the last few weeks with?
Your name is Chris Adetokunbo Nelson now. Chris, look at me. I'm your mother. Oh, you're talking Nelson. You are my son, my only child. Tokunbo. You mean my man. Koji. How about Kimberly? You two were engaged to, you know, to be married.
Yes. Your mother transferred you to Abeokuta to rescue the branch there. Uju and Oyelu in an accident. But since you've refused to talk to anyone anymore. Guy, even the work you did at Lagos, you mean you don't remember anything?
Kimberly?
Yes.
You remember her?
You both were engaged to be married. Do you remember her?
My God.
All right. I'm excited about this, but she cannot wait.
Wow.
I'm happy for you anyway.
Can I go about that thing you talked about?
Yes, I told you, I forgot. What's her name? Shirley's jewelry's accessories,
bridal.
Yeah.
I'm very happy. I think I love her gowns.
Wow.
But I would like to try them on. You know, that kind of thing.
So
we can go to her place.
When?
No. What are we doing? Are you doing anything? It's not our office. please, so it's not this thing you're doing.
Okay.
You want to do cheap rice meeting. You don't want to suffer.
Yes, ma'am.
You said you wanted a drink.
Mrs. Is that enough?
No, gosh. No, not once.
What? We need to celebrate now, you know. Get high every day. Finally, get married.
Thank you.
could.
Damian.
Yes, ma'am.
My boy is walking.
Ben, I want to hear you, but push your way, I don't know.
Into my entrance.
Please.
Look at my face. Look, it's your mom. Picture yourself and her. Can you remember when we took this picture?
I
me see this picture we took in the beach. See this one. Oh, I remember that day. You were so happy. You were so excited. Give me this particular object that you love so much. This one. We see it.
Chris, see. This is your bedroom.
Our bedroom.
To sleep here. You and Kimberly have always been here anyway.
Kepmon. Well, he's asleep and I'm sure he'll be fine. Hold on, mommy.
What is going on between you and Chris? Since Chris left Papi all the time, he refused to talk. What did you tell me?
Mom, it's nothing.
Kimberly, we're just wondering why you didn't pick up and said you left a note. Do I saw the note?
Wait. You saw the note?
Yes, I did. And is which fellows it is. Kimberly.
I saw Chris in bed with another woman.
God. Why did he tell me? Wow. He never told me. I'm sorry, Dad. People start believing that you're in trouble. Yes. Well, true. You see, today is woman. It's a forgiving.
Yes, those were the exact words in the note she left. Kim.
Please. I just want to get married.
That's the spirit.
Thank you, darling.
Thank you, girl.
Chris finds it difficult to say anything. She called off the wedding and he was too proud to mention it. He couldn't admit that he could. He would have talked about it. You see, women find their way around such things easier than men.
Something does not add up here.
What could that be?
It says, to hear is human, to forgive is divine. I am human too. I forgive you, Chris. I regret it. Got to go. Bye. She said, I am human too, and I forgive you, Chris. What could she mean?
How would I know, Damien?
Moni, I think those Chris work closely with Atata Bukuta would have something to say. With your permission, Moni.
Yes.
I would like to get to the bottom of this. Thank you, Mom. And Mom,
yes.
Please don't be worried.
I'll be fine. Thank you.
Hello, Ola. Yato Siwo, who else was close to Chris? Oh. Okay. Thank you.
Baby, it's our wedding soon.
Babe, look, Mommy's making every arrangement. She's so excited and happy about this wedding.
You don't seem excited.
How can I be excited about something I don't understand?
Come on, it's our wedding. You and I were getting married. It's not something to make you happy.
Were we ever?
Don't even go there. Oh my goodness. We were so, so in love. You loved me so much. We were so intimate.
Do I love you?
Really? How can you be asking me such questions? You love me so much.
Do you love
me? Baby. Kimberly loves her Chris so much, you could just die and do anything for him.
I see, in my head, Well, I guess so. I have images of
it.
Hey!
Oh, hey! Damien.
Chris.
Hey.
I missed you so much. Mommy.
Talk about.
Yes.
Thank you. See the account. That's what you want to
do. Yes.
Thank you. Thank you. Chris.
Damien.
Chris.
Baby.
Chris. Chris.
Babes.
My head.
Please. Babe. Baby.
No!
Babe.
My head. My head.
Baby. How much did you say the total budget is?
If you look at this page, you see that the total budget is 115 million and this is another budget for 220 million. Depends on what you want, ma'am.
I think I'll go for this, but I'll be paying you 200 million.
Ma, please, come up to 210 million. It's a very big package, ma.
Okay, 210.
Thank you so much, ma.
Yeah, ma.
Congratulations, ma.
Thank you, thank you.
You see, I'm so excited this wedding will eventually take place.
I was afraid Chris will cancel it. At last, I'm going to have my wedding.
Congratulations once again, ma.
Thank you. Thank you. So, check.
Sir, Oga is always with that woman. The first day they met, Oga just shouted. That's how the woman summoned courage to go and meet Oga that day. That was the first time that they met.
Later.
Oga now drank around 3 a.m. in the night. Oga could not move. He now called me. It's me and so without just gather him, put him inside the car. Before we took him home. At midnight, that's how Madame now called.
Madame called?
Yes.
Which Madame?
Ah.
Kimberly or the MD?
It's the MD. The MD. And he didn't pick. He didn't even pick that day. Because when he saw the call, he was upset. The call made him angry. He now started in the middle of the night. Started explaining to me in the middle of the night.
Okay, you go on.
Oga said he caught Kimberly. Kimberly with his friend, Siri. In his house. Even on his bed. He caught Kimberly. He caught the That's enough!
It's okay. It's okay. This is it. Somebody. Thank you.
You lied to us! You lied to us!
I will not have you
humiliate. You know what you did! You know what you did!
What
you are a liar!
You
are of the one
you
are a liar!
I will not have you insult me!
Who is insulting you?
You understand?
You are a bad person!
I respect
you! This woman is not your wife!
You broke off with her a long time ago.
Baby, just ignore him. I don't know what the hell he's talking about. I
remember you. I remember you.
Baby, you...
I remember you.
Husky Kimberly, what are you doing here? I remember you. I remember everything. I was supposed to travel to Ogun State that night. I changed my mind, came back home, I caught you pants down in bed with my friend, Cyril. I looked at you in the eye and I told you that you and I were done. That the wedding is off. And then you're here. Well, you're skimming, thinking that I will not remember anything. But I remember you. If you have any form of decency left in you, Kimberly, pack your things and get out of my house right now.
Go! Get out of my house!
What did I hear you say?
Mommy, I got someone.
I'm not going to marry a prostitute. Get out of my house.
Chris, your madness has started again. You were the cheating one. You cheated on her, she caught you, and she left. Instead of you to tell us the truth, you kept turning us around. Tell me, son, what exactly is wrong with you?
No, Mommy, can't show it off.
Save your breath, Damien, save your breath!
Mommy, please. That was the lie she fed everybody with. Oh no, Paro. Mommy, Chris, he bought more brain. He didn't get on my accident.
Kimberly, what is going on, Kimberly?
It's the truth.
Eh? Oh, that's why you lay. Oh, you're not watching. What did you say?
I just.
Boy. It's okay. It's okay.
Don't stop.
Come in, come in. Let's go.
My apartment this time.